Today, we're going to be learning all about color contrast and how exactly to test for it in whatever authoring environment you are in. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and thank you for joining me today. Under WCAG, there are a couple of different levels of conformance. For level AA, there is a minimum contrast ratio of 4.5 to 1. And for large text, 18 point and above, there's a color contrast ratio requirement of 3:1. Now, sometimes it could be a little confusing to keep track of the actual standards, so I highly recommend downloading a free color contrast checking tool, and today we're going to go over two of them. The first is called the Color Contrast Analyzer Tool from TPGI. I will provide a link in the description below if you want to download this tool. But before we dive in, please take a second to hit that like and subscribe button. Now, what's great about this tool is it has the WCAG 2.1 standards at the bottom of the tester. When we have text that is black font on a white background, we have the highest contrast ratio of 21:1. And what we're gonna do is just test a couple of colors. The first thing I'm going to do is using the eyedropper tool on the foreground color or font color, I'm going to select the color I want to test. In this case, I'm going to test the gray font. Sometimes this tool can be a little touchy and I needed to resize my windows. With that said, this gray font passes our 1.4.3, our 1.4.6, and our 1.4.11. We have a 7:1 contrast ratio. That is perfect. Something that's interesting about color contrast is typically it also applies to non-text content. So in this example, let's test this blue bullet that I use in my presentation. I'm going to select that color, and in my sample preview box, I'm just visually comparing that it's the same color, and this actually fails all of our color contrast requirements. What if I made my title maybe this green color that's built into Microsoft PowerPoint? What I'm going to do is use the eyedropper tool and test this green color. And currently it has a ratio of 2.1:1, which is a failure under AA and AAA requirements. But what if I were to highlight that color in black? Let's change the background color from white to black and ensure that our sample preview is correct. And it now passes our color contrast requirements. So sometimes you can apply a highlight to the background in order for it to pass color contrast requirements. Though if it were me, I would rather just keep the color black and keep things simple. Now, there's some pretty cool things we can do using the color contrast analyzer. Let's go back and test these colors again. And I'm going to select this slider option in the foreground color, and I'm gonna select this box called synchronize color values. And what I can do is actually drag this slider, and I'm visually looking at the sample preview below. And what this does is it allows me to find a color of green that's very similar, but that passes AA and AAA compliance. So if I keep sliding my color, we now have a new hex color we can use to replace our font color within our PowerPoint. So that is a brief overview of the color contrast analyzer tool. I also want to show you the WebAIM color contrast checker. This works very similar to our other tool. Essentially, we can come in here, use an eyedropper tool, and test in a very similar way. And it automatically updates to where we have a contrast ratio of 2.05:1, which fails under normal text, large text, and graphical objects and user interface components. So it fails under all of these things. Again, we can use the slider to move to different shades of that same green, and then take this color and come back to our PowerPoint to actually update the color to a passing color contrast example. So I like to use both of these tools. It just sort of depends on the project I'm working in. Sometimes the color contrast analyzer can be a little buggy. depending on where you are testing. And then similarly, the WebAIM tool is web-based, and you kind of have to have a lot of screen real estate to be able to test properly. It's important to note that color contrast also applies to things like bar charts and the labels that appear on this content. Now, there's a whole section on color and meaning, which I'll probably cover in another video, but it's important to test the values of the content inside of the bar charts. So let's go ahead and take this color picker, and we're going to take the blue font, and we can quickly determine that the white on this light blue font fails all of our color contrast requirements. Additionally, this color must pass against the background of the bar chart. In this particular case, I applied a black border around the content, which is enough to make it pass accessibility standards in terms of it being a graphical object. However, that label needs to be a different color, and we would want to change it to probably black, or have it highlighted black as in this example. So that concludes our brief demonstration on how to test for color contrast requirements. As always, I can be your personal accessibility expert, and I want to thank you for joining me today, and I hope to see you next time.